Hello and welcome to our channel, War Secrets. War is an intense armed conflict between states, governments, societies, or paramilitary groups such as mercenaries, insurgents, and militias. It is generally characterized by extreme violence, aggression, destruction, and mortality using regular or irregular military forces. Wars are fought with different strategies, and always the champion is the one who has the best strategy. A surprise attack can be a strong weapon in any war, and also is considered an adroit strategy to overthrow your opponent. Sudden assaults have toppled societies and shaken civilizations. The element of surprise can be a very potent change agent, and perhaps the most powerful weapon of all. One of the earliest accounts of the epic surprise attack comes from the Greek mythology, the Trojan Horse. In one version of the tale, the Greeks finagle a way to get a large wooden horse inside the city of Troy. Inside a horse, Greek warriors hide. They emerge and in a surprise attack, defeat the Trojans. Today, we are going to discuss similar incident which completely changed the course of the Second World War. Yes, we are speaking about the attack on Pearl Harbor. Watch the video till the end to know all about this surprise attack from the Japanese. Let's start our today's video, but just before we do, quickly subscribe to our channel and press that bell icon to never miss any video from War Secrets. So let's begin. Where is Pearl Harbor? Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, is located near the center of the Pacific Ocean, roughly 2,000 miles from the US mainland and about 4,000 miles from Japan. No one believed that the Japanese would start a war with an attack on that distant island of Hawaii. Additionally, American intelligence officials were confident that any Japanese attack would take place in one of the nearby European colonies in the South Pacific, the Dutch East Indies, Singapore, or Indochina. Because American military leaders were not expecting an attack so close to home, the naval facilities at Pearl Harbor were relatively undefended. Almost the entire Pacific Fleet was moored around Ford Island in the harbor, and hundreds of airplanes were squeezed onto adjacent airfields. To the Japanese, Pearl Harbor was an irresistibly easy target. What happened at Pearl Harbor? Pearl Harbor was the scene of devastating surprise attack by Japanese forces on December 7 of 1941. Just before 8 a.m. on that Sunday morning, hundreds of Japanese fighter planes descended on the base, where they managed to destroy or damage nearly 20 American naval vessels, including 8 battleships and over 300 airplanes. More than 2,400 Americans died in the attack, including civilians, and another 1,000 people were wounded. The day after the assault, President Franklin D. Roosevelt asked Congress to declare war on Japan. So let's have a look at the historical events leading up to this event. So why did Japan attack Pearl Harbor? In the late 1930s, American foreign policies in the Pacific hinged on support for China, and aggression against China by Japan therefore necessarily would bring Japan into conflict with the United States. As early as 1931, Tokyo had extended its control over the Chinese province of Manchuria, and the following years the Japanese cemented their hold on the region with the creation of the puppet state of Manchukuo. A clash at the Marco Polo Bridge near Beijing on July 7, 1937 signaled the beginning of the open warfare between Japan and the United Front of Chinese Nationalists and the Chinese Communist Party. In response, the United States government extended its first loan to China in 1938. In July 1939, the US announced the termination of the 1911 Treaty of Commerce and Navigation with Japan. Beginning in the summer of 1940, the US began to restrict the export to Japan of materials useful in war. Between June 1940 and the fateful crisis of December 1941, the tension constantly mounted. In July 1941, and had entered into an alliance with the Axis power, the US government severed all commercial and financial relations with Japan. Japanese assets were frozen, and an embargo was declared on shipments to Japan of petroleum and other vital war materials. Militaries were steadily gaining influence in the Tokyo government. They bitterly resented US aid to China, which by this time had been stepped up. They saw in the German invasions of the Soviet Union an unrivaled opportunity to pursue a policy of aggression in the Far East without danger of an attack upon their rear by the forces of the Red Army. Nonetheless, negotiations looking to find some kind of understanding between the United States and Japan took place through the autumn of 1941, and not until the end of November did it become clear that no agreement was possible. Although Japan continued to negotiate with the United States up to the day of the Pearl Harbor attack, the government of Prime Minister Tojo Hideki decided on war. What was the plan? The sudden attack in Hawaii, at the time a territory of United States, not a state, might have taken many by surprise, but the Japanese had been planning the operation for months. Admiral Isoroku Yamamoto, commander-in-chief of the Japanese naval forces and architect of the Pearl Harbor attack, didn't want to fight with America, but much of Europe and Asia, including Japan, were involved in World War II at that time. Yamamoto wanted to take over certain countries in southern Asia and use their oil to help fuel Japan's military vehicles and naval fleet. But because the US base in Hawaii was relatively close to these countries, the Japanese worried that the United States would send soldiers from the Pearl Harbor to defend the nations if they were attacked. By destroying the US military presence in the region, the countries Japan wanted to target would be left vulnerable. So Yamamoto decided to move forward with a surprise attack on the US fleet in Hawaii. So on November 26, 1941, 31 warships carrying fighter planes and bombers slipped from Japan into the North Pacific. They moved silently until they closed in on the Hawaiian Islands. A small Japanese plane made a loop around a target and radioed back Pearl Harbor sleeps. Bad luck due to weather. The United States was caught unprepared for the attack on Pearl Harbor, but things might have turned out differently were it not for some bad luck. The United States had broken a Japanese diplomatic code in Project Magic, and General George Marshall, having been handed a decoded Japanese message on the very day of the attack, had sent the word to the US base at Pearl Harbor prior to the assault to be on the alert. Atmospheric conditions delayed the transmission of the Marshall's message, and it did not arrive until the attack. Moreover, the United States had known that a Japanese attack was imminent somewhere in the Pacific, but the US military government personnel had thought the Philippines or some other area of the South Pacific closer to Japan was likely the target. Pearl Harbor was 3,500 miles from Japan, and had seemed to the US government and military was unlikely a target. After Pearl Harbor, the United States rapidly mobilized for World War II. How did they attack? At dawn on December 7, 350 planes launched in two waves from Japan's ship. The bombers dropped bombs on American warship below, while the fighter planes targeted the US aircraft on the ground so they couldn't fight back. Following both attacks, 19 US naval vessels were sunk or damaged, 188 aircraft were destroyed. In all, 2,280 servicemen and women were killed, 1,109 were wounded. 68 civilians, people who are not in the military, also lost their lives. The attack lasted just under 2 hours. What happened after the attack? Repair crews went to work on the ships. Except for USS Arizona, Utah, and Oklahoma, every damaged ship returned to the sea. The day after the attack, the United States declared war on Japan, officially entering World War II. In the nearly 4 years that followed, the US Navy sank all of the Japanese aircraft carriers, battleships, and cruisers that participated in the Pearl Harbor attack. The United States and its allies Britain, France, and Russia, among other countries, eventually won the war, defeating Japan and its allies Germany and Italy. The 7th of December 1941 will be remembered as one of the darkest days in America's history. The question as to whether this tragedy could have been averted still piques curiosity. We believe the Pearl Harbor tragedy could have been prevented. The United States had a lot of information that should have allowed them to prevent the attack on Pearl Harbor. For example, the codes that have been picked up from Japanese vessels giving information about the mode of attack, i.e. aerial assault. Lastly, the SCR-270 radar sets installed on Pearl Harbor have detected a massive inbound flight about 45 minutes in advance, but the warning was ignored due to the inexperience of the handling crew. As is often the case with great tragedies, negligence and extreme bad luck combined to bring about this catastrophe. Are there any other defining events in the history of modern warfare you would like us to make a video on? Do let us know in the comments. That's the end of the video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed your time watching this, don't forget to like and subscribe for more informative content. Stay tuned for our next video. See you all next time. Later.